Children, I assume that Nina ma'am has introduced you tables, just the initial how to display a table on a web page. Today I'll talk in details of all the attributes and all the different things which are possible through table. I'll wait for another 2 minutes. Let everybody get in.
Good morning, sir.
Good afternoon.
Good afternoon, sir. चलो भाई यूट्यूब से करते तो ठीक है.
Quickly, all of you people who are left with, mark your attendance in the chat window.
Okay, sir.
It's already 12:24. 1 minute, I'll wait. Okay, children, can I start?
Yes, sir.
Okay, excellent. Now see, I think Nina ma'am has already introduced you the table. Now what I'll do is, I have created a folder, HTML tables. If you can see on the screen, the whole content I'll share with you in the group. Okay, so there's nothing, you don't need to write down anything. But if I give you some kind of concept or some type of explanation which you think it is important, you can write down on your copy. Okay. Now to begin with, I have the first table, which is table 0.html. I'll just click and see the web page view of this table 0. Look at this. This is a table. See, there is no border in this table. There are three rows and there are four columns. One, Raman 5678, two, Rohan Sharma. There are three rows and four columns. This is the basic table in HTML. And now I'll show you how does the HTML looks like for this basic table. Now, if I see the HTML, I'll open this file using Notepad. And look at this. This is very simple. I can increase the font size so that it is visible more clearly. Okay. Now look at this. Minimize this. Fine. Now the coding as well as the HTML web page view, both are in front of you. Now coding is, I have written something very simple. In title I have written working with tables HTML. If you see the title part, it's coming in the web page title bar, working with tables HTML. This is what from the title text. Okay, and then coming down, this is the table tag. Inside the body, there is a table tag, and I haven't specified any attributes here in the table tag, right? That is why I'm getting the very basic table there without any border, nothing else. And under this table tag, I have three TR tags, if you see. The first TR and then the closing TR. TR stands for table row, okay? So TR opening, TR closing. Again, I have TR opening, TR closing for the second row, and then I have for the third row. Let me take down this. Yeah. So, if you look at it, there are three TRs. TR opening, TR closing, TR opening, TR closing, again TR opening, TR closing. And within this TR, I have TD. TD stands for table data. TD, please mute your microphones, all of you. And within this TR, this table row, I have one TD, second TD, third TD, and fourth TD. That means there are four columns. Okay. So for every TR, I have sir. Four. Yeah.
Hello.
Yes.
Sir, kuch bache enter nahi kar pa rahe.
In the beginning I have told you that within the first 5 minutes you have to enter, otherwise I'll get disturbed. I have a lot of things to cover today. Okay
sir.
Now you don't need to bother about that. Now whatever I'm explaining, please try to understand this. So I have three rows. So I have three rows here, first, second, third, and this is the basic table structure. There, I haven't used any attributes. I hope you understand what is an attribute. With every tag, see table tag, I have certain attributes. Okay. And what are the attributes? What are these attributes used for? To format the table, to make it more decorative and attractive. With, you know, the way things are understandable more. Fine. Now, this is your basic table. I think this has been covered by Nina ma'am. Now, I'll just close this. I'll go to my second HTML file. Second is table 1.html. Okay. I'll just click it first and see the web page preview. Okay. This is the web page preview. Now I'll go to the HTML coding for table 1.html. Yeah. Now this is your HTML code. I'll just minimize this so that it is easy for you to see. Okay, now I'll make it okay. I think, anyways, I'll admit the people who are in the waiting room. Okay, now this is fine. Now look at my second table, table1.html. This coding, in the beginning I have used comments. This comment I have explained you in my first class. Okay, this is the way you can give comment in HTML. So what I have written in the comment, I will be covering border, DG color, width and height of the table. Table is the tag and these are the attributes which I'll be covering here. Okay, if you see the web page preview, the color of the table is yellow. Okay, the first thing. And then you have one border which has come. And the border, you can see there is certain width in the border. Okay, border of the table. And then one more important thing which you can see that the size of the table has increased, and which has, you know, which has produced gaps in between the contents. Okay, so these are the new things which has got introduced from the previous one, which was a very basic and raw table. Now, how do I get this? Now, coming to the HTML coding, I see in the body, see, I haven't written anything, nothing in the body attribute. Okay, then I come to the table tag. In the table tag, I've introduced border. Border is an attribute which I have given the value as 1. BG color is the second attribute. Remember, BG color is an attribute of body tag also, right? If I use BG color in the body tag, that means the whole HTML web page will be yellow color if I give yellow in the BG color in the body tag. But I haven't given that. What I wanted, because if you see the HTML preview, the rest of the things are white. Only the table is yellow. So in the table, attribute border is equal to 1, BG color is equal to yellow, and then width is equal to 400. Width is equal to 400 pixels. That means the table width. Width means this is the width. Can you see the mouse pointer? One of you?
Yes, sir.
Okay, very nice. So the mouse pointer, you can see this is the width of the table. And height of the table is this. This is 300 pixels. So I have introduced BG color, width, height, and border. Okay, rest of the things are all same. If you see the TR, TD, nothing has been introduced. So use of border is, if border is 1, then this is the, suppose I change the border to 4. Okay, the border size to 4. I save this and I see the effect here. I refresh. If you see the border, you know, the border size has been changed. It is 4 now. The thickness of the border is 4. Now, if I change to 7 and I save it, again, you can see the difference here. See, the width, the thickness of the border has increased. It is 7 now. Suppose I make it 0 and see what happens. If I make it 0, it has gone. That means it is very similar to what I have done in the previous one, where I haven't given any border. Border attribute I haven't used in the previous one, the raw one. So it is very similar to that. If I do border is equal to 0 or I do not specify the border, the effect is same. Even if I remove this border and I control S, I'll get the same effect. Okay, see, refresh, I got the same effect. So what is the purpose of border is to give the size, that is the thickness of the table border. If I say 3 and BG color, you can change the BG color. If I say BG color is equal to green, so automatically you'll see the changes comes here, the green color comes here with the thickness. Okay, the border size. I hope this is clear. Is this clear, one of you?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Very nice. Now, yes, I just saved this. I will be sharing all these files with you. Don't worry. You can practice it by looking at it. Now, I close this. I'll go to my second, that is the third one. The third one is table2.html. I'll come to table2.html. I see the web page view here. Okay, and then I'll see the coding. I'll see the coding here. I'll open this file using Notepad. Okay, fine. Now, here what I try to explain is, I have given you in the comments. these comments are especially for this. You know, if I use comment, then the comment part is not displayed on the web page. That is the speciality of comment. Comment is only used for documentation purpose. Now, what I have used here, I have used the border again. I have used the BG color again. That is why you see the border of the table as well as the background color, which is yellow. Okay. Now, you must be wondering, sir, itna chota kyun aa raha hai? I can increase the size. This is just a zoom. I have used the zoom. I'll just increase a little more so that it is visible to you properly. Okay. Now, fine. I come back to my coding. Oh, sorry. Right. I'll reduce the size of this window. Okay. Now it's okay. Now, two more things which I have introduced here, that is TR and TD. In TR tag, I have introduced height attribute and width attribute. Okay. And in TD, I have explained the use of V align. V align is an attribute of TD. Now, coming down here, table border. Now, the first row, okay? If you look at my code, so that it is easy for you to understand. Now, table border is equal to 1, BG color is equal to yellow. Now, the first TR, this is your first row. I'm talking of the first row. TR,
light.
Yeah, any question? Any question? Okay, Harshit. Harshit, 10D. No question? I'll continue. See, in the first table row, okay, I have given the height is equal to 100 and width equal to 60. This is the first table row. Okay, height means this is the height. If you see the height of the first row, it is quite size is from here to here, that is, this is 100 pixels and width is 60. Width means this is the width. Okay, the first row width is 60. Okay.
Sir?
Yeah.
Sir, how to we have done Rohan Sharma's marks, so can we add any subject there?
And marks, yes, in, yes, this subject. Definitely, I'll come to it. That is why I have so many web pages for you. One by one, I'll introduce and tell you how to do what. Okay. So, okay. For this particular file, I have introduced two things. The first thing is your V align. Okay. And the second one is height and width of rows. Remember, initially, in the last one, I have introduced height and width for the whole table. This is only for a row. We can set the height and width of a particular row. The first row, I have set the height as 100 and width is 60. You can see the difference here. And the align, V align, if you look at it, TD, V align is equal to middle. Okay, middle and 1. If you look at it, vertical alignment, that means in if you see vertically, 1 is where? In the middle. It is not on the top, not at the bottom, it is in the middle. Okay, so V align, middle, and then in the second column for Raman, I have written V align is equal to top. Okay, see where vertically Raman is on the top. Okay, not in the middle now, it is on the top. And again, for this third one, 83, I have said V align is equal to bottom. That means it is coming at the bottom. Now, suppose I want Jack. Okay, now Jack, I want. Now, V align will be visible only when if you set the height of the row. Suppose for Jack, 3 Jack 65, I change the height of the table row. Okay. I say H-E-I-G-H-T, height is equal to, I say instead of 100, I say 150. Okay. And I save it. And you see the difference here. For Jack, the height becomes 150, right? Now, suppose I want to place Jack at the bottom. Okay, so how do I write for Jack? This is the TD for Jack. And in TD, I'll use the attribute V align is equal to bottom. Once I do this, I save this and I'll see the difference here. See, Jack has gone at the bottom. Is this clear, all of you? be align and height and width? One of you?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
We are going step by step. Okay, don't worry. I'll be covering everything. Right? Now, this is your table 2. I save it. I close these 2 files. Then, I move to my table 3. Table3.html. Okay. Table 3. And then, I'll open the HTML code for table 3. Right. Now look at this. You can see image at the background. Right or wrong? Can you see the image? One of you?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
So here, see what I'm trying to explain you. What all things I have used. In the table, I have used a border. I have used the BG color. Oh, I will not use BG color. I'll remove this. Because when you use the background, then BG color, you know, is not shown. If you are not using background, then BG color is shown. Okay. I removed the BG color. I have used align. I have used height, width. TD, I have used align. And then background. Okay. Now, see, here what all things, you know, new things which you can see. One is that Rohan Sharma, the size of Rohan Sharma is quite bigger, right? While rest of the text, if you see Raman, 1, 2, Jack, 3, all are, you know, of same size. But Rohan Sharma, the size of the text has increased. How do I do this? This is important. Okay. For Rohan Sharma, see, if I go down. Now, if you look at the second row, okay, I have highlighted. The second row, TR, beginning, TR, ending. Okay. And then, first TD, I'm leaving first TD because first TD talks of the roll number, that is 2. Second TD, okay, second TD is this much. And inside the TD, I have used the tag font, okay, and the attribute of the font is size, which we have already covered in the previous class about font, okay. So, using the font tag, I have increased the size of Rohan Sharma. Okay. So if you want to increase the size of any cell text, okay, you have to use the font tag for that. Right. This is one. Second thing is I can see that the whole table has a background image and the image is a parrot. Okay. For this, what I have done, what I did was first, I first locate where is my table3.html. Okay, this is there is a folder called HTML tables. Inside the HTML tables, I have all the files. Out of these files, table3.html is the file. And here itself, I have stored a image file that is p.jpg. p.jpg is the image. If I double click, you can see the image of a parrot. If I use paint, you can see. Yeah, any question? Now, the size of the parrot is very small. I have intentionally kept it very small. Why? I'll tell you the reason. Now, so one thing is very important. If you want an image for a table, background image, you have to create an image or download from internet one image, and that image extension should be .jpg and it has to be stored in the location where your HTML file is. Okay, so both has to be same location. And then what you do is in your coding, again I open up table3.html. yeah, I got it. See, what did I do here? I'll get it here because it is not shown. Yeah. In the table is the tag where I have border, align is equal to right. Okay. Height is equal to 300, background, weight, all these things. Even background, instead of keeping it here, you can bring it after in the beginning itself or anywhere. Okay. The sequence doesn't matter. So what did I write? Background is equal to p.jpg. Okay. So if you remember, in body tag also we have an attribute called background. If we specify in the body tag, then whole web page, this white portion will also be filled with the parrot image. Okay. But now we want the parrot image as the background of the table only. For that reason, I have introduced this background attribute in the table tag. If you see p.jpg, border is equal to 1. Now, here I have one more thing. Align is equal to right. What does this mean? Align is equal to right. This is another thing which is introduced here. See, now look at this. The table is in the right side of your screen. Okay, this is align is equal to, this is align, remember. Abhi just pehle hum logo ne kiya tha V align. V align is for the table data. Okay, table data. Inside the cell, humne kya kiya tha V align mein, we have used top, middle, bottom, if you remember. Now, we are actually trying to put the table in the either in the middle or in the left side or in the right side. Okay, for this we'll use the tag align, and this align tag is for which we, this is for table tag. Now look at this, align is equal to right. Okay, if I change the right to center and I say control S, I come back here, I do a refresh. Now see, automatically the table shifted in the middle, okay, in the center. Okay, so two things which you have learned here. In fact, three things. One is how to place the table, whether right side, whether left side, or in the middle. For this, I'll be use this align attribute inside the table tag. And then I have changed the size of Rohan Sharma, which I have done using the font tag inside the td tag of tr, that is the inside that particular row inside td tag. I have used the font tag for that. Okay. And the third thing which you have learned is the placing an image inside the table. Now, one more thing. See, can I ask a question now? The question is, suppose I increase the size of the parrot. You know, the size abhi hamara ek bahut chota tha. Agar main hum is size ko bahut bada kar dete hain, to kya hoga is table ke andar? Anyone can give me the answer.
Piche ka background mein jo likha wo sab hat jayega. Matlab visible nahi hoga wo.
No. Anybody else?
Sir, change nahi hoga kuch.
Na, image ke size agar main thoda bada kar deta hu, to kya hoga?
तो सर सिर्फ एक ही इमेज दिखाई देगी,
वो इमेज बड़ी दिखेगी,
टेबल के बैकग्राउंड में आ जाएगी इमेज.
या यू आर वेरी क्लोज टू इट. मैं एक बात बताता हूं, ओहो, वी आर यू नो लेफ्ट विद लेस टाइम. एनीवेज, नाउ व्हाट विल हैपन इज, अगर हमारा पिजन पैरट का साइज थोड़ा सा बड़ा है, तो इस टेबल में देखा जाएगा कितनी ऐसे इमेजेस आ सकता है. और अगर थोड़ा सा बड़ा है, नंबर ऑफ इमेजेस विल डिक्रीज. और अगर साइज काफी बड़ा है, तो एक ही इमेज नजर आएगा. ओके, तो ये देखा जाता है इस टेबल में उस साइज का कितना एकोमोडेट हो सकता है, उस हिसाब से इमेजेस आएगी. अंडरस्टूड? अंडरस्टूड ऑल ऑफ यू?
यस सर.
ओके, नाउ आई विल क्लोज दिस एंड देन आई गो टू माय नेक्स्ट टेबल 4.html. Actually, this 40 minutes is very less. Next time I'll take YouTube, where there is no limitation of time.
Sir, that is very nice.
YouTube live I'll do. Because, you know, many people have requested for Zoom. That is why I have come back to Zoom. Zoom has 40 minutes limitations only. Okay, now look at this. Very interesting. I have used new things here. The very important thing which I have introduced is cell spacing and cell padding. Now, what is cell spacing? Cell spacing means the border thickness. That is, if you see the thickness of the border, okay, can you see my mouse pointer? This is the thickness, okay. And what is the meaning of cell padding? Cell padding means that the cell ke andar jo bhi likha hua hai, wo content or border ke saath kitna distance hai. Okay, this is, now I'll see, I'll do some changes now. Now, this cell spacing and cell padding, these are the two attributes of the table tag. Now, yahan maine 20 kiya hua hai. Suppose isko main cell spacing ko 5 kar deta hu, ghata deta hu, aur cell padding ko main 10 kar deta hu. Okay, that means abhi humne kiya kya hai? Cell spacing ko ghataya hai, cell padding ko badhaya hai. Let's see. Look at this. Cell spacing मतलब वही border देखो कम हो गया. मेरा mouse pointer देखो पहले ज़्यादा था अभी कम हो गया. Cell spacing कम हो गया. While cell padding देखो roll number का आगे पीछे कितना gap बढ़ गया. One के आगे पीछे कितना gap बढ़ गया. Raman के आगे पीछे gap बढ़ गया. I hope it is clear. One of you.
Yes sir.
Cell spacing and cell padding. Okay,
yes,
now I have introduced one more tag, that is caption. See, after the table tag, before the first TR starts, I have used a tag called caption. Caption ke andar maine kya likha hai? Students data. Upar dekho table ke upar students data nazar aa raha hai. Ye matlab table ka ek naam de diya maine. Theek hai? This is your caption. Caption will do. Okay, now inside TR, एक और इम्पोर्टेंट चीज तुम देख रहे हो जो ऊपर रोल नंबर नेम मार्क्स वन मार्क्स टू ये एक नया मैंने इंट्रोड्यूस किया है ठीक है ये हेडिंग है इसलिए यू विल सी दैट नाउ हाउ मेनी टीआरस वी हैव फोर टीआरस फोर सेट्स ऑफ टीआरस क्योंकि हमारे पास चार रो है एक रो दो तीन चार सो पहला टीआर के अंदर हमने टीडी के जगह पे यूज किया टीएच टीएच का मतलब है टेबल टेबल हेडर ओके TH शुरू TH खत्म TH शुरू TH खत्म I have four sets of TH तो इसलिए हमारा रोल नंबर नेम मार्क्स वन मार्क्स टू देखो कितने बोल्ड में आ रहा है तो ये TH के वजह से है ओके और उसके बाद हमने एक और चीज नया चीज देख रहा हूं मैं रोहन शर्मा वाली रो का कलर चेंज हो गया है बैकग्राउंड कलर ये मैंने कैसे किया अब रोहन शर्मा वाला कौन सा TR है ये वाला TR है ये कौन सा थर्ड वाला रो है फर्स्ट टीआर सेकंड टीआर थर्ड टीआर ये थर्ड है इसमें हमने टीआर के अंदर एक मैंने एट्रीब्यूट यूज किया बीजी कलर ठीक है जो टेबल में भी मैंने यूज किया येलो यूज किया टेबल के साथ और टीआर के साथ हमने ऑरेंज बीजी कलर इज इक्वल टू ऑरेंज इसलिए मेरा रोहन शर्मा वाला रो ऑरेंज कलर हो गया है आई होप इट इज क्लियर एक और चीज देखो मैंने मेरे को लगा जो जैक के बाद 45 का बैकग्राउंड कलर मेरे को चेंज करना है तो मैंने क्या किया अब नीचे मेरा 45 वाला में मैं जाऊंगा रो में और उसकी टीडी में जाके मैं लुक एट दिस ये मेरा लास्ट रो है ओके लास्ट रो 3 जैक 45 अब देखो टीडी ये मेरा पार्ट देखो हियर व्हाट आई हैव डन बीजी कलर इज इक्वल टू रेड कर दिया सो दैट मेरा फोर्थ रो की थर्ड कॉलम का सेल रेड हो गया पीछे I think this is clear, all of you.
Yes, sir.
Any doubt here?
No, sir.
Okay, I'll share all this with you. What you can do is at home you can practice all these files. Okay. Now I go to my fifth one. I don't know how much time I have. 4 minutes. Anyways, let's see. I have now. What did I do? Table 4 or table 5 now? Let me see. I have done, okay. Table 4 I have done. Table 5.html. I'll open this. Okay, excellent. Now I open the coding also. Now look at this. इसमें तुम्हें क्या नया नया नजर आ रहा है जो सबके कलर ब्लू है ना रोल नेम मार्क्स वन मार्क्स टू सबके कलर ब्लू है ये मैंने कैसे किया इफ यू गो डाउन इन द बॉडी, बॉडी जो हमारा टैग है, बॉडी टैग के अंदर मैंने टेक्स्ट इज इक्वल टू ब्लू किया है, राइट। टेक्स्ट इज इक्वल टू ब्लू का मतलब है बॉडी में जो भी होगा सबके कलर ब्लू हो जाएगा, ओके। दिस इज योर टेक्स्ट इज इक्वल टू ब्लू। देन और क्या इंटरेस्टिंग चीज हमने किया है, इफ यू सी दी देयर आर टू, ऊपर वाला जो रो है वो काफी बोल्ड आ रहा है, रोल नेम मार्क्स वन मार्क्स टू, और नीचे वाला एक और रो मैंने इंसर्ट किया है, रोल एंड्स नेम एंड्स, प्लीज नो टॉकिंग, कीप योर माउस म्यूट, ओके। सो आई हैव हाउ मेनी रोज, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 रोज। तो फर्स्ट रो एंड द लास्ट रो मैंने ये दोनों का बोल्ड हो गया है, ठीक है। तो हाउ इट हैपेंड, यू कम डाउन टू माय कोडिंग। Now, after the table tag, I have introduced a tag called T-head. Okay? T-head में मैं जो भी डालूंगा वो bold आएगा शुरू में। मैंने डाला हुआ है role, name, marks one, marks two, TH के साथ। तो इसलिए मेरा यहाँ पे ये changes आया है। If you see my T-foot, T-foot, oh, I think I... Okay, now please no talking. Okay, now in T foot, I have introduced role ends, name ends, marks one. So T head, please mute your microphones. Okay, T head and T foot are two things. T head means एकदम ऊपर वाला T header row आएगा, और T foot मतलब एकदम नीचे वाला row है, और बाकी हमारा जितने भी रोज है उसको डालेंगे टी बॉडी के अंदर, ठीक है। तो टेबल के अंदर हमारे पास तीन सेट्स आ गए, टी हेड, टी फुट, टी बॉडी। इनको किसी भी ऑर्डर में हम इसको रख सकते हैं, पहले टी फुट रखो, टी हेड, टी बॉडी, किसी भी ऑर्डर में रखो, उससे कुछ फर्क नहीं पड़ेगा। बट टी हेड में हम जो भी रखेंगे वो रो की टेबल की सबसे ऊपर नजर आएगी, टी फुट में हम जो रखेंगे वो एंड में एकदम आखिरी में नजर आएगी, और टी बॉडी में हम जो रखेंगे वो बीच में नजर आएगी, ठीक है। दिस इज द यूज ऑफ टी हेड, टी फुट एंड टी बॉडी, ओके। यू नीड टू प्रैक्टिस, वंस यू प्रैक्टिस यू विल अंडरस्टैंड। नाउ अगर मैं बॉडी की टेक्स्ट हटा देता हूं, यू विल सी द कलर विल बी ब्लैक, ठीक है, सारे ब्लैक हो गए। बट यू कैन सी द डिफरेंस ऑफ द फर्स्ट रो एंड द लास्ट रो, दोनों बोल्ड में आया है। दिस इज बिकॉज ऑफ टी हेड एंड टी फुट। और एक चीज और इंटरेस्टिंग, जो यहाँ जैक का कलर देखो रेड आ रहा है, खाली कलर रेड आ रहा है। हाउ डिड इट हैपन, एंड विच आई थिंक आई हैव ऑलरेडी टोल्ड यू इन वन ऑफ द टेबल, दैट इज उस जैक जहां पे लिखा हुआ है, जिस टीडी के अंदर, वहां पे मैंने क्या इंट्रोड्यूस किया है, फॉन्ट टैग। फॉन्ट टैग से हम उसकी कलर को रेड कर दिया, जैक का कलर, ओके, फाइन। आई सेव दिस, आई क्लोज दिस, and then I have the last one. I don't know how much time is left for me. Let's see.
One minute. Okay. Over, most probably last का ही है.
Okay. If I cannot finish this, I'll finish it in my next class. Okay. This talks about two things, that is.